Hello everyone, I welcome you to my channel. Today I am going to show you how to install Anaconda in Windows 10 operating system. So, let's begin. Now, before installing Anaconda Ide, you need to first understand what this Anaconda Ide basically is. Anaconda Ide is basically a software using which you can do machine learning related project. So inside this Anaconda Ide, you'll be seeing there's basically two very important IDE. One is this Jupyter IDE and another is this Spyder IDE. So both these IDE are basically used for machine learning related project. Now, to install Anaconda IDE, you need to first download it. So for that, just simply go to your favorite browser and in here, just simply type Anaconda download, then enter. And then you'll be seeing this www.anaconda.com is basically our first search result. To install, just in the first, simply click on this individual edition Anaconda. This will be automatically going to open this Anaconda official website. You first, you know, simply accept these cookies and all, and then just, you know, simply click on this get started. This will, you know, automatically going to open this pop-up, and here you'll be seeing this download Anaconda installer option. So, you know, just simply click on that, and here it will, you know, automatically going to redirect you over here. And here you can clearly see under this Anaconda installer there is basically three downloading options. So one is this Windows operating system, another is this macOS, and another is this Linux operating system. So depending upon on what operating system you are using, you need to just simply proceed with this download option. So in this video, what we are going to show you is this how to download this Anaconda for Windows. So you know, here you can clearly see that they have these two options. One is the 64-bit Grafica installer and another is this 32-bit Grafica installer. So I am using this 64-bit Grafica installer. So you know, just simply going to click on this 64-bit Grafica installer to download our Anaconda. This will, you know, automatically going to start your Anaconda, and here as you can clearly see, our Anaconda is now currently downloading. I have already downloaded it, so just you know, simply cancel it. And if I just go to my download directory, you can clearly see this Anaconda has been, you know, rightly downloaded over here. To install our Anaconda, just, you know, simply double click on it, and then just, you know, simply minimize my download directory. And here I can clearly see our Anaconda 2020.11 setup wizard has been, you know, rightly open. In here, just, you know, simply click on next to proceed with our installation. And here it's currently showing this license agreement. So, you know, just, you know, simply click on this I agree. And then they basically gave these two options, so just me and all users. Now this machine is basically, you know, used by me only. So what I'll be doing is, you know, just, you know, simply click this just me, and then just, you know, simply click on next. And this is going to be, you know, our installation destination, that is this Anaconda 3. They basically, you know, going to create this Anaconda 3 directory, and then just, you know, they're going to be installed there. If you want to change your installation destination, then you need to just simply click on this browse and you can change that. And this is very important, guys. You need to have at least 2.7 GB of free disk space in your C directory. I have currently available space is the 59.7 GB, so it's adequate enough to install Anaconda. So this is very important, guys. You need to also check whether you have this amount of free disk space in your C directory. So this 2.7 GB of free disk space is required. So, you know, after checking all this, just, you know, simply click on next for installation. Now here under this advanced installation option is basically, you know, showing whether we like to add Anaconda 3 to our path environment variable. So for which, you know, I have already installed this Python, so, you know, I am not going to check that. If you are installing Anaconda for the first time and also you haven't installed Python, then you need to check this. Otherwise the installation is going to be failed, and also you need to install Anaconda again. So if you have already installed Python, then just simply uncheck this. If you haven't installed Python, then check this. So this will, you know, automatically going to install Python. All right, so now that I have already installed Python, just, so just, you know, simply uncheck that, and then simply going to check this register Anaconda 3 as my default Python 3.8 and then just, you know, simply click on install. This will, you know, automatically going to start your installation, and if you just simply click on the show details, it will, you can clearly see that how the installation is actually happening. It will take a couple of minutes, so for which, you know, I'll be coming back once when it gets done. Yeah, so welcome back. And now, as you can see, our Anaconda installation has been rightly completed. So just, you know, simply click on next. And now it's also telling to install this PyCharm IDE. So, you know, just I have already installed PyCharm IDE, so you don't need to install in this way. But if you still want to install, then just, you know, simply click on next. And now you can clearly see that, you know, our Anaconda 2020.11 setup has been, you know, rightly completing. So, you know, just simply uncheck this because I don't want to, you know, check any tutorials, or also don't want to see any get started with Anaconda messages and all. So, you know, just simply uncheck that and just, you know, simply click on finish. So now that you know your Anaconda has been, you know, rightly installed, if you just simply go to your search icon and in here just simply type Anaconda, you'll be seeing this Anaconda desktop app has been, you know, rightly over here. So, you know, just simply click on that to open your Anaconda. And now, as you can see, our Anaconda is now currently launching. So it will take some time if you are using for the first time. So now, as you can see, our Anaconda has been, you know, rightly launched. This is basically the GUI interface of Anaconda. Here there are several tools like this, you know, terminal, then this data load, then this IBM Watson Studio as well. But the most important two tools is this. If you just, you know, simply scroll down a bit, you will get to see this Jupyter Notebook, and the version is 6.1.4. And if you just again scroll down a bit, you will see this Spyder 4.1.5. So these two are the very important IDE for which, you know, this Anaconda is very much, you know, special. And as you can clearly see, this PyCharm Community Edition is also there. So I have already installed this PyCharm Community Edition. So right now you don't need to, you know, install PyCharm. But if you haven't installed PyCharm, so in that case you will see this type of, you know, install button. To install, you need to just, you know, simply click on this install. And also, you know, if you want to code your machine learning program in this R language, then, you know, you need to click on this install to install this R Studio. So this will, you know, give you a very good interface for, you know, your R programming. And they have this, you know, other IDE as well. VS Code is what, you know, I have already installed, so it's now currently showing launch. But the two important IDE, that is the Spyder and Jupyter, has been, you know, rightly installed with this Anaconda. To launch our Jupyter, just, you know, simply click on this launch. And then you can clearly see this is now currently showing this launching notebook, and it will, you know, automatically going to open your browser, and here it will, you know, automatically going to open your this Jupyter notebook inside this localhost 8888/3. Here you can create a new file. So for that, you know, just, you know, simply click on this new, and then we are basically going to, you know, create a new Python 3 file. So for that, you know, just simply click on this Python 3. So this will, you know, automatically going to open your new tab with Python 3 as our, you know, language. So here you can test your whether this Anaconda has been, you know, rightly installed or not. So for that, just, you know, simply print hello world in our console. So hello world, then, you know, just simply click on this run button. So here you can clearly see this hello world is basically, you know, shown in our console. In here you can install packages. So for that, if you want to, let's say you want to install TensorFlow, so for that, just, you know, simply type pip install TensorFlow, and if you just click on this run button, it will, you know, going to be installed TensorFlow. I'm not going to, you know, install TensorFlow right now, it will take some time. I don't want to do that. I want to show you this another IDE called Spyder. So for that, you know, just simply click on this launch, and here you can clearly see that it's currently stating this launching Spyder. It will, you know, going to be launching your Spyder IDE, and here you can clearly see this Spyder 4 is now currently launching. So just, you know, simply minimize this Anaconda. And here you can clearly see that our Spyder has been, you know, rightly launched, and it's currently, you know, asking whether we'd like to install Kite, and also stating that Spyder 5.00 is also available. But I don't want to, you know, install 5.0, it will take some time, so just, you know, simply click on dismiss, because this Spyder 4 version will also do your work. You don't need to worry about that. If you just, you know, just simply test whether the Spyder is working properly or not. So for that, if you just, you know, simply type hello world, and if you just, you know, simply click on this run button, and, you know, just simply click on this run, you can clearly see this hello world is basically shown in our console. So in this way, you install Anaconda in your industrial operating system, and I have also shown you how to use these two IDE called Spyder IDE and this, you know, Jupyter IDE. So that's all for this video, friends. I have this website called geekyscript.com. In here you will be seeing various tutorials along with some blogs that I have written. So do check our website geekyscript.com. So that's all for this video, friends. Thank you very much for watching this video. If you like this video, then please give it a like, and also do share with your friends. Thank you very much for watching this video, and God bless you all.